It's time to make the stator of the motor. The stator carries the coils, and the number of coils have to do with the number of faces of the motor. Stepper motors are multi-phase motors. They have a minimum of two faces, and the more the faces they have, the smoother they rotate, and the more steps they can achieve per cycle. Now, this particular motor has two faces, and this means that it carries four electromagnets in a cross pattern. These are here the armature of the electromagnets. The coils are winded on these armatures, like this. Now, to understand how the stepper motor works, you need to understand first how the coils are aligned. The coils are in pairs, first of all. The top and bottom coils, as you look this video, are perfectly aligned with the center of the shaft. And this is the first phase of the motor. This is the first pair. And the same happens, of course, with the right and left coils. They are also aligned perfectly with the center of the shaft. And this is the second phase of the motor. This is the second pair. The trick is that the first pair and the second pair of the coils are not perpendicular. Actually, in our example, they have an angle of 90 degrees plus the angle for each for one step of the motor. Why? Well, this has to do with the operation of the stepper motor. Let's take a closer look to this armature. Suppose that the rotor has stopped in this position. The teeth of the armature are aligned in between the teeth of the rotor. Now, when the coil of this armature is energized and the armature at this point becomes a south pole, for example, then this tooth of the motor will be attracted by this tooth of the armature, and this tooth of the motor will be impulsed by the same tooth of the armature. And the same will happen with these three teeth over here, and also with the last three teeth. So finally, because of this, the rotor will rotate just one step. And of course, there is the other electromagnet opposite this one that will act exactly the same way, as these electromagnets are pairs. The rotor north poles will be aligned with the armature teeth that are currently south poles. Right. Now, watch what happens to the other electromagnet pair. If you look closely, the teeth from the armature are between the rotor poles. This is actually the reason why the electromagnet pairs are not perpendicular. There are of course other type of motors that have maybe a different number of teeth or a different number of phases, and sometimes the pairs must be perpendicular for the motor to operate, but this has to do only with the geometrical characteristics of each motor. In our example, the pairs must not be perpendicular. Now, on the next step, the vertical pair will be de-energized and the horizontal pair will be energized. And if you take a closer look, you will see that here happens the same situation as before. The north poles of the rotor will be attracted to the armature, that is right now a south pole, while the south poles of the rotor will be impulsed by the armature teeth. The rotor will then make another rotation step, and the teeth of the armature of both electromagnets will be aligned with the north poles of the rotor. And now the vertical pair, if you see, the vertical pair is ready to make the next step. The teeth of the armature are between the poles of the rotor. The horizontal coils will be de-energized and the vertical coils will be energized. But now they will change magnetic polarity and they will become north poles. This means that the south poles of the rotor will be attracted, the north poles will be impulsed, and the rotor will make one more step. Then the phase will change, the vertical pair will be de-energized, the horizontal pair will be energized, and the motor will make one more step. And actually, this is the way it goes. It's very simple, and that is the principle of operation of the stepper motors. Now we need to complete our construction, and there are not actually much to do, just to put the housing of the motor. The electromagnets are fixed on the housing and the rotor is free to rotate on the ball bearings. And a little before the end, the cover is placed, and now I will make the housing transparent just to have a better look inside there. And the last part to put is a sprocket and the motor ready. That's about it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to visit our website for more interesting theory and circuits.